Okay, last question for today's Q&A. Yes, you in the back. Oh, you. I watch your YouTube all the time. Marlon Flores, right? Yes. Okay. Oh, for the record, my favorite book is Romance. Yes, yes. What was your question?
Okay. Sometimes I don't feel like sharing my faith. Ano ba yung dapat gawin?
Thank you for that question. That is a wonderful question. Pag-usapan natin. Step number one is identify, meaning identify the problem. What is causing you to not want to share your faith? Now, oftentimes, tell the truth, nahihiya ka na. Oftentimes, lahat tayo, medyo nahihiya. And it's usually a reaction to this world, feeling like we're going to be judged, people are going to frown upon what we have to say, that we're judgmental ourselves, that we're being self-righteous, that KJ tayo, a number of things. But at the end of the day, it's a lack of confidence that causes that. And so, identifying that it's a lack of confidence, a lack of faith, ironically, that causes you to not want to share your faith. Now, what's another reason that may add to that struggle that we have of sharing our faith? Another one is, quite simply, sin. An issue of the heart. Oftentimes, we are not grateful for God, we're not grateful for His blessings, and oftentimes we're ashamed. We're ashamed of ourselves, we're ashamed of our own sin, we condemn ourselves, we may be going through a rough patch that's causing us to anger easily, to be impatient, to be unkind, to be unloving. And oftentimes, these conditional aspects of our works, our performance, is what causes us to be shameful, when in actuality, sharing our faith is talking about what God has done, not what we have done. And so, identifying that these are the obstacles that cause a hindrance in us sharing God's work in our hearts is step number one. Step number two is identity. And now you move towards, what is your identity? What are you sharing when you talk about sharing your faith? Your identity is in Christ. And so reminding yourself of your identity in Christ, that's not about your work, it's about His work on the cross. And so, meditating on the Word, seeking quality quiet time, and when need be, the readily available church. Seeking support and love and reminders of who you are in Christ from brothers and sisters in Christ. And really meditating on that to overcome that hindrance that we identified with earlier, that struggle of being bold enough to share our faith. And step number three is purpose. Now, what is our purpose? Our purpose is to be the salt and the light. We are to be ambassadors of Christ. Now, that word ambassador, we hear that so often nowadays. I mean, brand ambassadors. I mean, with the whole TikTok, Instagram, social media thing happening. Being an ambassador of these brands, honestly, everybody wants to do that. Everybody wants to be an influencer. Everybody wants to have that kind of presence on social media. All the more, we should be that excited and that enthused to be ambassadors of Christ, to be influencers in being Christ-like. And so with that, with our struggle to sometimes want to share our faith, all the more we should be encouraged to be who we are as Christians, ambassadors of Christ. We don't need to earn it. We don't need a certain number of likes, comments, or followers to be it. We just be who we are and obeying our obedience to Christ, even when it's not convenient, even when it's not something that can be fulfilling as far as being embraced by the world or embraced by the people that surround you. All the more you're doing it for Christ, all the more you are glorifying God. I hope this has encouraged all of you to share your faith confidently. If you guys have any other questions, please comment below. At the next time, pag-usapan din natin yan. I'm Brian Santos. Peace and God bless. If you like this video, we have weekly content about evangelism.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel and download Yes He Is app for free.
And please do follow us on our social media account @YesHeIsPH. And let's live
life on mission.